Hey, this is your boy Jay Hinn with Jay Hinn Traveling Services, and I'm here to talk to you guys today about Club Mo Bay. Okay, you guys, so I recently went to Jamaica in June. I went there June 5th through June 10th of 2021. And while I was there, I took advantage of the Club Mo Bay Departure Lounge. Well, you might not know what Club Mo Bay is. I'm here to tell you about that in this video, and I'm gonna let you know if I think it's worth it or not. So Club Mo Bay is pretty much like a VIP lounge that they have there at the Jamaican airport in Montego Bay. And what it does is kind of like to get you fast track through, like, you know, customs, immigrations, and you get actually a place to go and lounge. You get a place to go and get some food, some drinks, either before your flight or after your flight. So what I did was I wanted to do the arrivals, which I think arrivals is the so when you take advantage of Club Mo Bay, you do get fast-tracked through security, customs, and immigrations, as well as you get personalized assistance for your arrivals when you arrive in Montego Bay. So one of the things that's very important is if you're arriving in Montego Bay, I don't even think they got air conditioner there. It's like an open air airport. You arrive there, it's hot, it's burning up. And on my trip, I waited too late to the last minute to try to book Club Mo Bay, so it was already sold out. So we were going through customs, immigration, security. It took us like 2 hours to go through that. I mean, we probably stopped at like 2 to 3 different screens before we entering in information, filling out forms, and then going through the actual security checkpoint before we could even get to our bags. And I'm telling you, the line was long, it was hot, and I really wish I could have took advantage of Club Mo Bay. And the reason why is that when you take advantage of Club Mo Bay, they actually have someone that comes and greets you when you get off of your airplane before you even get to the first line to turn in now the travel authorization forms that are required due to COVID. You'll have someone there that's holding a sign. They'll greet you, and then they'll escort you through the fast track lines to where you can get to the computers that you need to get through to fill out your information. You'll get to turn in your travel authorization forms faster, and then you'll actually get fast tracked through their VIP lounge. And at the VIP lounge is a place where you can take advantage of unlimited food, unlimited drinks. They do have a menu that you can order food from, a menu that you can order drinks from, or whatever alcohol and liquor there that they have there, you can actually tell them to make the type of drink that you like. They also have showers there, so if you're one of those people, you want to go to your resort all fresh and showered and things like that, you can do that right there at Club Mo Bay. They actually have an area where you can connect to Wi-Fi, like a business area. You can look at the newspaper, the local news, and things like that. If you got to connect your phone to Wi-Fi, you can take advantage of the Wi-Fi that they have there in that area as well. Let me just look to make sure I'm not missing anything that you might want to know. You know, they have hot and cold beverages, as well as tapas, sandwiches, fruit, and other snacks. You can take advantage, like I said, of the Wi-Fi, and you can catch up on the latest magazines and newspapers, which is all complimentary right there for you. And then, like I said, you get that fast track service through immigrations, customs, security. So it does allow you to have that stress-free experience because you're not waiting in line, and then you can just get through everything a lot quicker doing it that way. Like I said, they do have a fully equipped business center, and you can access Wi-Fi while you're there. They also have an area where you can make phone calls to the United States using a landline phone. There's also assistance with retrieving your luggage. They have private restrooms. You know, if you want to have your own private restroom area, you know, they have private restrooms back there. That's just another plus of taking advantage of Club Mo Bay, because, you know, when you're out in the airport area, you know, it's the big, huge bathrooms, maybe waiting in line. Club Mo Bay, you can go use your own private restroom in privacy. So let me take you through the arrival. So when you arrive at Club Mo Bay, you'll get off your plane. You'll go to the Club Mobe meeting point where your representative will be there waiting for you, like I said, when you get off the plane. If you have to fill out your immigration forms because you haven't done them on the plane, you can fill them out right there. And then you breeze through customs, you breeze through customs and immigrations with your fast track access. Your host helps you to receive your luggage. And there's also relaxing reggae music that's played there. They have televisions there, and there's also different options for seating. They have, you know, lounge chairs, chairs in a restaurant area. They have bar stools. They have like chairs that are almost like couches, you know, where you can sit down. And it just all depends on the setup that you want. They have chairs that kind of have the cushioned backs to them that almost are set up like booths and things like that. So you can choose the environment that you want to sit in, and you can be away from the crowds when you arrive into Jamaica. Or even if you don't want to take advantage of the lounge like that, at least you can use it to get fast track through customs and things like that, which I think is an actual plus. So what I did is I did the departure lounge, because like I said, the arrival was already booked and sold out, which I think the departure lounge is less likely to sell out. But with the departure lounge, you do have to go, once you get your ticket at the ticket counter, there's a Club Mobe desk right before you go to where security is, and you just stop at the Club Mobe desk. But you do have to walk yourself through the airport when you're coming back on departures. So you go, you check in there, they give you your boarding pass or ticket for Club Mobe, and then you just go and you walk through a fast track line to go through security. So the day that we did departure, it was not crowded at all, so I was thinking like both lines were moving at the same pace because there was nobody in line. It wasn't a single person ahead of me, and the people that was coming in, it was nobody ahead of them. So it was just like me walking through, putting my stuff through the security scanner and going through. Now, if it was a busy day and the TSA line or the airport security line was packed, I could really see the benefits of going through that departure lounge. Or if you plan on getting to the airport like extremely early, and then you can have some time to chill out in the lounge once you walk to that part and get past security, because you do have to walk yourself through there. You don't get a private escort. But then once you do get to the departure lounge, you still have the same amenities that the arrival lounge has. So they have two separate lounges. There's one for arrivals, one for departures. But even when you go to the departure lounge, you get the same thing: unlimited hot and cold beverages, alcohol, snacks, tapas, sandwiches. There's a menu that you can order from. They do have showers, the private restrooms. There is like some spa services that they have there for additional fee. But it's just like that relaxing environment. There's tons of places to charge your electronics, your cell phones. You still have like access to Wi-Fi if you have to take care of any work or do any last minute things before you get on the airplane, just to be in like a relaxing environment. And it's air conditioned, so you're in there, it's cool breeze flowing through there, which on that other part, I don't know what's out there. I don't know if they got air conditioner or not. I just know when I arrived, I was hot as hell. So there's my take on Club Mobe. If this is your first time checking out my YouTube channel, please hit that subscribe button down below. If you got any questions about Ochos Rios, Montego Bay, anything like that, leave me a comment down below. And check out some more of my videos that I have on my YouTube channel, as well as my videos from Jamaica. Peace.